Hey, what's up guys? I'm Theojo, and by now you've hopefully heard of the WannaCry infamous ransomware computer virus that's been going around the past couple weeks. If you somehow aren't, here's the quick summary. Earlier this year, there was a bunch of leaks from the NSA that revealed unpatched Windows exploits. And these exploits actually had been patched for a while in most recent versions of Windows, but as you know, not everyone keeps their operating system up to date. For example, there are millions and millions of computers that still run Windows XP, which is no longer even being updated. And even for more recent versions like Windows 7, some people have updates disabled for some stupid reason. All of these people, which included people like businesses that were too slow to upgrade, were vulnerable to these exploits. And these exploits were pretty nasty. The main one is known as Eternal Blue, and you didn't even have to do anything to become infected. The exploit allows someone to directly connect your computer out of nowhere and take over. After the virus infects one computer, this is WannaCry now, it has access to the entire local network and uses that computer's file sharing services to infect every other computer it's connected to. So not only that, but the virus will actually patch the exploit once it's infected in the computer, effectively shutting the door behind it so no other viruses can get in and steal control again. But the worst thing about the WannaCry virus is what it does after it infects the computer. I've talked about ransomware before, which I think are probably the most evil kinds of viruses out there, and this type of virus will encrypt all of the files on your computer, making them completely useless and inaccessible unless you have the encryption key that was used in the first place. And to get it, the virus demands a payment of $300 in Bitcoin and double that if you wait too long. So the pressure is on. And eventually, if you don't pay it, it threatens to delete the encryption key, locking you out of your files forever, basically. Now, WannaCry has been one of the most talked about viruses in the mainstream in a long time, both because of how damaging it is and also because of how widespread it has become. There were hundreds of thousands of computers in 150 countries infected, even including some hospitals where medical equipment systems were infected and rendered useless. So is there anything being done about all this? Well, obviously the answer is yes. People are working hard to fix it if possible, or at least stop people from getting it. And the first line of defense is to simply keep your computer up to date on security patches that fix the exploit. If you're running something like Windows XP, you need to get with the program because that operating system is not receiving updates anymore and more exploits will be found. It's only a matter of time. And in this case though, Microsoft did decide the exploit was so bad that they actually released an emergency patch for Windows XP, even though they said it's no longer supported. They decided, you know, this is bad enough. But don't expect that to keep happening. This was a special case. And there's really no reason to not keep Windows up to date on the latest patches. However, I will concede that for a lot of the major updates, like the anniversary update for Windows, it did have a lot of bugs. But usually you aren't forced to get those major updates until a while later, so by then, the bugs should be fixed. And you always want to get the security patches right away at least. Besides staying up to date with patches, you should also have an antivirus. As I've said countless times before, you might think you're too smart or too familiar with computers. Oh, I'm good with computers, I don't get viruses. But WannaCry is proof that that's not true. The next time an exploit is found, it might not be patched yet, and you're left completely vulnerable even if you didn't do anything wrong. No matter how smart you are, you'll still get it. I think the best thing to do is get an antivirus software that both scans for viruses, obviously, and also has internet security features, meaning it's gonna block attempts that you might come across online from infecting you in the first place, just from browsing, like drive-by attacks. And while Windows does have built-in antivirus, it really isn't that good. You probably want to go with a good third-party one, and there are free ones out there, so you can look those up. The third thing you need to do, and I do mean need to do, is back up your computer. How many times have I said this? And not only that, but you'll want to do it in a way where the virus can't infect the backup as well, which I'll talk about later. The importance of backing up your computer should be pretty obvious. It's not even mainly about viruses, that is part of it, but rather the fact that your hard drive will fail eventually. All of them do. If you just keep all of your important files on your one computer and that's it, you're playing with fire. Hard drives don't give you much warning if they're gonna fail, if they do at all. And once they do, you can't get your data off it. In some cases, you can spend thousands of dollars and send it to a data recovery company, but it's still not a guarantee. You just want to back up and save yourself the trouble in the first place. And we actually know from research done by Backblaze, a backup company, how often hard drives fail based on their data that they use a lot of hard drives. In the first year and a half, you can expect a 5% failure rate. That's a 1 in 20 chance that you'll lose all your data within a year and a half of buying your new computer. And if you make it past a year, chances are it will survive the next year and a half. So if they're gonna fail, it's either gonna be after a few years or right at the beginning. But after that 3-year mark, they saw a failure rate of nearly 12%. And it obviously gets worse than that. Now, I know that many of your computers are older than 3 years old. Heck, mine is about that old. So right now, you're sitting here and there's a 1 in 10 chance that your hard drive will fail this year and you'll lose everything. All right, so I think you get my point. So let's get back on topic about how to actually back up your data. It's not as hard as you think. Modern versions of Windows all have built-in backup features that make it incredibly easy. And you just plug in an external hard drive that's big enough to fit your stuff, enable Windows automatic backup, and wow, you just save yourself a lot of headache. But that's not all you should be doing, because consider this, maybe that external hard drive isn't as safe as you think. Maybe a thief breaks into your house and steals your computer and steals the hard drive along with it. Or in the case of WannaCry or any other ransomware, it's gonna see that backup drive attached to the computer and encrypt everything on there too, so it defeats the purpose. You have a couple options here to solve this problem. First, you could disconnect or turn off the external hard drive between backups. This way, if your computer gets infected, your backup is physically separated from the virus and is obviously safe. The other option, which I think is the best, is to use an online cloud backup service. There are a few out there. There's like Backblaze, Carbonite, CrashPlan, and others. And the idea is the same for all of them. The software runs in the background and uploads all your files to the company servers for backup, so you don't have to worry about it and handling it yourself. And every time you do add a new file or update it, it will update the copy on the backup server. And if some of your files do get encrypted by the virus, the service should have an option for version file history, so it'll still have the good copies on there. Or at least hopefully, you probably want to check that before you buy the service. So now that you know all about WannaCry and how to protect yourself against it, you might be wondering what's next. Unfortunately, this is all gonna just get worse, seriously. Hackers all over the world are gonna see how effective and profitable a virus can be like this and try to make their own. This always happens. And they'll be working overtime to discover new vulnerabilities all the time. And because of how effective ransomware is, I don't think there will ever be an end of it. I actually think that ransomware is going to literally be around forever because the concept is so simple. I mean, even as computers get more and more powerful, the hackers can just use stronger and stronger encryption indefinitely. It's just a matter of how they infect people in the first place. That's the only thing that would change. Oh, and would you look at that? There is actually a new virus already going around. That didn't take long, did it? The latest threat is called EternalRocks, and believe it or not, it could be even worse than WannaCry. Because not only does EternalRocks use the same couple of exploits as WannaCry, it actually uses 7 different exploits found in the NSA leak. So this way, it can infect way more computers because there's more entryways and it's more likely to infect a computer that it comes across if one of those patches isn't patched. So what is this EternalRocks virus anyway? Well, it's kind of interesting because it's been spreading but hasn't actually done anything yet. You see, once the virus infects your computer, it spreads itself to other computers in the network if it can, but otherwise stays invisible to the user, so you might not even know you have it. But the scary thing is that the hackers wouldn't have just made this virus for nothing. It has a purpose, but they're clearly waiting for something, and we don't know what it is. One possible obvious explanation is that they're trying to infect as many computers as possible right off the bat, and then finally activate it all at once they have a sufficient number. And if people don't know that they have the virus, they aren't gonna try and remove it, so it makes it much easier to spread initially. And as I mentioned, we aren't even sure what this virus is going to do. It could just download any set of instructions from its creator at any time. They could decide to launch a ransomware campaign, or turn it into a botnet to attack major websites, or even sell the botnet to another hacker group. We don't know. In any case though, I bet we'll find out soon enough, and if we're lucky, the authorities will maybe find the virus creators and shut them down before they can even do any real damage. But until then, the best thing you can do is follow the same steps I laid out before. Just stay up on your security patches as soon as they're released, have an antivirus software installed just in case, and of course, use backup as a last resort. But you always want to do backup. Unfortunately, I think most people are not going to do all these things. As I mentioned before, a lot of the vulnerable computers are on businesses or in less developed countries with lots of old computers. And the hackers know this, which is why this type of thing is just gonna keep happening. I mean, even as new versions of Windows come out, maybe Windows 7 is gonna be the old version that gets exploited. It'll just keep going. So the main thing you wanna do is just really focus on protecting yourself. Anyway, I think that just about covers everything, and I really hope this was helpful to you guys who weren't aware of these risks, and even if you were, we'll be more vigilant going forward. I'd like to hear what you guys think down in the comments section, and be sure to check out other people's comments as well. They're usually pretty good ones. And if you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can click on those. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. Again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.